Okay guys, so first of all, this title is not clickbait. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can turn your Excel data into an interactive dashboard like this one here in just a few seconds. There is no coding required, and no, we are not using any kind of AI tools or whatsoever. Instead, we will use my new Excel add-in. To create a single chart, you just need to select your data, click a button, and then you will have a fully interactive chart saved as an HTML file on your machine. As you can see, the chart includes animations, a data zoom slider, and you can even switch the chart type dynamically. Now, here's the cool part. Once you create the single charts, you can use the dashboard builder to put them all together in one single HTML file. Now you have an entire dashboard ready to share with your colleagues or manager. This dashboard can have tabs, or if you prefer, you could also have a single page dashboard like this one, where each chart is placed in a grid. Or if you need more flexibility, you could create a draggable dashboard where you can resize and reposition the charts as you want. And since the dashboard is in HTML, you could also host it online. In my case, I just manually added a bit more text and a button to the dashboard and then hosted the dashboard for free on GitHub Pages. I know you might be thinking, okay, that's cool, but why not use a simple Excel chart, Power BI dashboard, or even create a custom dashboard using Python, just like I also showed you here on my YouTube channel? And this is a great question. In my opinion, each and every tool has its own specific use case for different kind of reports. Let me explain. From my experience as a data analyst, there are typically two different scenarios: ad-hoc analysis and standard reports for the most common KPIs. Depending on the situation, you will want to choose how much effort and what kind of tool you use to visualize your data. Let's pick the standard report for example. Depending on the industry you work in, you might want to show the company's financial situation, track the performance of your warehouse, monitor costs in cost centers, or whatever you need to track. In that case, it makes sense to use a BI solution like Power BI or Tableau. Depending on your needs, you could also even create an entire dashboard using Python, for example. However, for ad-hoc analysis, that might be a bit overkill. By ad-hoc analysis, I mean if a stakeholder approaches you and asks you for some sort of analysis, like how much money we could save if we reduce travel expenses, outsource certain projects, and so on. To answer those questions, I typically crunch some numbers in Excel and then present my analysis. Sometimes just having a nicely formatted Excel table with my analysis to deliver my findings might be even enough. However, in many cases, it helps your audience to understand your data better if you create some kind of visualizations. Here, instead of creating a Power BI report, I would normally stick to a regular Excel chart. If I need something more fancy, I might consider creating a Power Pivot chart. The issue is that sometimes I really just want to share my charts and not the entire Excel file with my stakeholder. In this case, I would typically copy and paste the charts into PowerPoint, add some comments, and then attach my slides to an email. Yet, of course, then you are missing the interactivity, like slicing the data or selecting only certain data points on your chart. And I know it sounds a bit crazy, but adding that interactivity to charts was actually one of the reasons why I learned Python in the first place. I simply just wanted to create interactive charts from Excel data. And if you go back to my first videos here on YouTube, you will see that it was all about turning Excel data into interactive charts using Python. However, I quickly realized that it was simply too much effort. It wasn't really practical to spin up a new Jupyter notebook or create a Python file for each and every chart. That is actually why I created my first add-in, called My Tool Belt, to transform Excel ranges into pandas data frames and Jupyter notebooks. With that, you just need to select your range, click a button, and then you have your data in Python ready for any kind of analysis and visualization. However, you still need to code out the chart, which of course also takes time. So now, a couple of years later, with more experience in Python and VBA, I created a new Excel add-in called Grafly. With Grafly, you can now create interactive charts and even entire dashboards right from Excel without needing Python installed on your machine or messing around with any code. Let me show you how it works. Once you have Grafly installed, you will have a new ribbon in Excel. To create a single chart, you can use the chart builder. For this example, let's start by inserting a new sheet with some sample data. Next, you can choose the chart type you want to create. I'll go with the bar chart for this example. The image here on the right side is to guide you on how to select your data. So, first I'll select my labels, and then I'll select the data I want to plot. The title and subtitle are optional, so I can just leave them blank. Now, to create the chart, just click this button here. Alright, and afterwards your default browser will open with your new interactive chart. Here you can now click to hide or unhide certain products. And this chart now is saved as an HTML file in your workbook's directory. Since this is a local HTML file, all the chart data is already contained within it. That means you do not need an internet connection to open the chart. Additionally, the chart is super lightweight. It is just a couple of kilobytes. So you could easily attach it to an email if you wanted to. In the same folder, you will also find a config file. This file will be important if you want to create an entire dashboard. But before we are creating the dashboard, let me show you some additional settings you have. So for that, let's create a line chart. As before, I'm selecting my labels and data. Additionally, this time I'll provide a title. Now, if you click on the settings button, you will see all the additional settings. For example, you can change the theme, the legend, and the title and data label positions. Here, I'll also add a data zoom, add a toolbox, and turn it into an area chart. Optionally, you could also change the axis settings, the font family and size, or the overall layout. However, for now, I will stick to the default settings, and when I click the button again, we will have our area chart. As before, this chart is fully interactive. So, down here, we have our data zoom, where you can now zoom into a specific data range. In the corner, you will find the toolbox, allowing you to save the chart as an image with a single click of a button, or even dynamically change the chart type. For example, you can display the data as a bar chart, or even change it to a stacked bar chart. Also, if needed, you could also change the data points. For example, when I set April to 100 and refresh it, you will see the updated chart. On my website, I've actually created a few demo charts that you can check out. So here you can also find a horizontal bar chart, a pie chart, and a scatter plot. To switch between the different charts, you will have these tabs. And creating this kind of dashboard is actually super easy. You will just need your settings files that were generated earlier. So, back in Excel, open the dashboard builder. Here you can select all the charts to include in the dashboard, so the settings files. Optionally, you could reposition the tabs, change the tab names, or apply a background color for the dashboard. After that, just click this button here, and you will have your dashboard, where each tab now contains one chart. Again, this dashboard is super lightweight. In my case, it is just a few kilobytes in size, so you could easily attach it to an email, for example. And if you prefer a single page dashboard, you could do that too. Back in Excel, you have the option to automatically arrange the charts on one single page. When you activate this option and create the dashboard, this is what it looks like. Now we have two charts next to each other. Optionally, you could also deactivate this feature, and then all the charts will be placed one after another. However, if you need a bit more flexibility, you could also use the draggable layout option. If you activate it and generate the dashboard, you can now reposition and resize the charts however you want. Okay, and that's how easy it is to create an entire dashboard from Excel data in just a few seconds. And since all the charts and the dashboards are saved as HTML files, you could also turn them into an actual website. For example, I hosted my dashboard for free on GitHub Pages and added a custom domain. In my case, I also manually added some padding, a bit of text, and also a button. So this could be a great option if you want to share your analysis with everyone. Now that you have seen Grafly, let me point out a couple of things. Like I mentioned, I don't see Grafly as a replacement for traditional Excel charts or Power BI reports. I see it more like another tool in your toolbox. If you want to quickly create an interactive and impressive dashboard without spending hours using Power BI or custom code, then Grafly might be a good addition to your toolbox. Also, I'm actively developing Grafly, so more chart types and options will come in the future. But this all depends on user feedback. That is why I have set up a feature board where you can submit and vote for new features or report any bugs you might encounter. And whenever there is a new release, you will be notified via email with a link to the release notes so that you can see what exactly has changed. Now, if you're interested in Grafly and you want to try it out yourself, then check out my website. It will be the first link in the description box. I don't have a free version, but I do offer a 14-day no-questions-asked money-back guarantee, so you can simply test things out and see if you like the add-in or not. Also, keep in mind it's a one-time payment, so you buy the tool once and you can use it forever. There is no subscription or any other hidden fee. For the first 20 data nerds who want to give it a try, I will leave a coupon code down below in the description, which you can use for a special discount. Alright, and lastly, if you not only want to impress your manager, but also make them smile, then you might also want to check out Cuteplots. It's a very light version of Grafly, but instead of professional looking charts, you can create interactive cartoon charts and dashboards with it. If you're interested in that, then check out the video on my website. Alright, and that's all I have for you. Now you might also know the reason why I haven't posted much here on YouTube recently. I was basically busy developing the add-ins and also working on my website. Okay, and with all that said, I'm really curious about your opinions about Grafly. Just let me know in the comments down below. And as always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.